it's the most amazing thing. Every panel, the one question that is asked the most is, who is your favorite character? And, or what is your favorite food? Or what, everything has to do with favorite. So I try to live my life as though whatever I do, he's become my favorite guy on stage. You're my favorite audience. This is my favorite chair. Anyway, my favorite character. I really don't have a favorite character because I love them all. I love the Silver Surfer. I love the Doctor Strange. I love Spider-Man. I love the Hulk. All of them. But when people ask me that question, I want to make them happy. So I always say, Spider-Man is my favorite character. And everybody in the audience goes, yay! Anyway, Spider-Man is my favorite.
What about your favorite actor?
Well, I think maybe Robert Downey Jr. The other day, you know, this is so funny. You got people way over there and way over there. I don't want them to be annoyed. I'm trying to look there. I'm an addict. Robert Downey Jr., I said to him, does anybody ever call you Bob? He said, I didn't expect that answer. Yeah, sure, you can call me Bob, you can call me Bobbo, you can call me Robbo. I don't care. It sounded so unlike Robert Downey. So I now call him Bobbo. So he's my favorite so far.
Hi, Sven. I've always heard that you never wanted them to kill Gwen Stacy.
And oh, no, no, I'm not bloodthirsty.
My question is, what would you have done with her and Peter if she hadn't ever died?
Oh, I would have had fun. Spider-Man would have had two girlfriends. No, what happened was, it was really odd. In one of my stories, I killed Captain Stacy, her father. And I thought it was kind of dramatic because he wasn't supposed to know that Peter Parker was Spider-Man. But as he lay dying, he said to Spider-Man, take care of my daughter, Peter. And Spider-Man knew that Captain Stacy had always known that he was Spider-Man, but didn't do anything about it. And I thought that was a very dramatic and touching moment in the comics. Then, for some reason, I had to go to Europe, and I asked Jerry Conway to write Spider-Man until I got back. So when I got back, I found out he had killed Gwen Stacy. And I said, I just killed Captain Stacy. Now you killed his daughter. What have you got against the Stacy family? But he had killed her, and I couldn't do anything about it except try to fire him. But they somehow keep bringing them back, don't they?
Yeah, we got Spider-Gwen now. What do you think about Spider-Gwen?
I haven't read it, really. My eyesight isn't that good anymore, so I can't read the comics. I hear about these things, and I marvel at them. Spider-Gwen. I don't understand it, but he'll explain it to me and confuse me even more. Can I answer the question?
Yes.
Okay. What was the question? Doesn't matter.
Hi, Tommy. Thank you. I've been a huge fan of Wolverine since I was 6 years old. I just find out Sage recently, and I wanted to know if is there a chance Sage will be in a movie or will be back on comics soon? Because I think she's not has been completely as a character. Sage.
See, my problem is I heard everything she said, but I couldn't make out the words. I just heard the sounds. What were the words? Oh, I'm going I'm gonna give you the most honest answer I've ever given anyone. I really do not know. I have not discussed that with anybody, and nobody mentioned it to me. And John and Joe Quesada ran out of here before we could ask him. So I don't know. I don't know any more about it than you do. See, now that's as humble as I've ever been.
It's a pleasure. Thank you so much.
You're very welcome, Soma. Is it coming from there? It's here. Well, the speaker is there. That doesn't mean the person is there. The person is there, but the speaker is there. It's very interesting. The speaker, I look where I hear it, but it's not coming from where I hear it.
There you go.
These panels are very difficult to handle.